Now we have a keynote address by Pawan Gadia, CEO, Retail and Online, GCC and APAC Regions, Ferns and Petals. Welcome, Mr. Gadia.
Thank you, ET Brand Equity, for having me here to present the keynote on the subject of performance marketing. Marketing and especially performance marketing is a subject which is very close to my heart. And I have seen the fortunes of our company go up and down because of performance marketing. I still remember around 11 or 12 years back when a credit card was added to Google AdWords account. And we watched in wonder how the life changed for all of us. And I'm sure all of you must be have gone through the same experience. With performance marketing, it opened a huge influx of traffic, a new set of customers, and the resultant top line was very thrilling. However, over the last few years, performance marketing has got democratized, wherein now everyone can use the same tactics to accelerate growth. And because of which, the cost of per lead or traffic has become so expensive. And if it is not done well, can be a reason for many of the organizations to perish. We all know that high CAC, customer acquisition cost, is one of the main cause for businesses to shut down. So unless performance marketing actually performs and we do not get the same customer through paid channels again, this becomes a waste. At Ferns and Petals, we are present in 4 countries and with a budget of 100 crores for this financial year, purely on performance marketing. I do not want my peers here to think about anything about performance marketing, but I have a couple of questions which are as to how do I create a sustainable marketing budget, keeping profitability in mind. When I see some macro trends which are compelling me to ask these following questions, as some of these are going to create very large impact in the marketing ecosystem in coming times. Is your data strategy robust to create a first party database? Lots of ads that we are seeing today on web are driven by third party cookies that trades and tracks your data, even your personal identity. That is the reason various browsers such as Safari, Firefox, Chrome are in the process of phasing out the same. Therefore, it is imperative to create and maintain a robust customer data platform, a CDP platform, which captures all the first party information in a structured manner, let that be clickstream or transactional data or anything else. Secondly, GDPR. After the enforcement of said regulation, which is already enforced in a couple of countries, and we are soon going to be embracing that, it is very important to maintain the confidentiality of the customer data in order to avoid data breach. Heavy penal provisions are there. And plus at the same time, if we lose the data, the customer loses trust with the brand, which is more expensive than any other penal provision. Thirdly, iOS 14 in Apple's policy will prohibit certain data collection and sharing unless people opt in into tracking. As more and more people opt out of tracking of iOS devices, ad personalization and performance reporting will be limited for both app and web conversions. So what is the strategy to solve this? Coming to my next question is, are your performance marketing costs structured towards optimizing on the LTV of a customer? As a business owner, I do not get too concerned with the number of leads or traffic that we are getting. However, once we get the customer in the database, how do we ensure that we continue to get in touch and engage the customer through remarketing and retention techniques so as to that cost incurred to get the customer is converted into LTV? Marketing is one of the biggest costs of a company's P&L, and one has to be very careful towards this spend, which sucks in a large amount of revenue. And gentlemen, I have seen revenues worth 30% of your top line or maybe more getting consumed in performance marketing. So this is a very frightening number and one has to be very careful about it. The way we should not be doing a 120 rupees spend to get a sale of 100 rupees, whereas it should be the other way that we are spending 20 rupees and getting a business of 100 out of it. Retention marketing and not just an acquisition mindset is what we need to focus on. One can easily get discount hunting customers from affiliate sites. However, the harder part is to get traffic from sources like organic and continue to work with the product team to make sure that we retain them eventually. The LTV has to be very clearly kept in focus. And with our experience, app as a model, majority of your customers downloading the app and working and shopping with you through the app is one of the best ways to maintain this. The third question being, is performance marketing job to get acquisition regardless of new or returning classification of users? No. Ideally, it is to get more and more new acquisitions at optimized cost. We have to be mindful of having a common dashboard for the entire marketing team. SEM or SEO, if they are not collaborating with each other too, and they are working on the same lead, then why are we even doing it? All departments of marketing, whether it's search, social, or app spend teams, have to come together. The CAC should be efficient, put together by all lead source, and basically having a growth mindset and not just lead generation. It should convert, and not all the departments should be chasing the same customer separately without visibility to each other and spending large amounts there. Competing with organic sources, wherever organic ranking is better, how do we ensure that with SEO ranking and not bid on those keywords and let SEO do the job? How about A/B testing this theory and spend more money where it is needed rather than keywords on which we anyways are ranking on top of SEO? For example, brand searches for FNP. The customer is already looking for us. And when he lands on the search page, we should not be brand bidding on the same and paying for it. Let us not compete various departments with each other. And this is especially more relevant for newer market wherein the website takes time for organic space for initially, as it's very important to do performance marketing. A zero-sum game with respect to competition, or you can make your own narrative. Our marketing strategy can't be reactive and needs to be proactive. For example, competition is increasing the CPC bid on AdWords. And would you do that even while knowing it's not profitable to do? And would you want to, or would you want to make your own narrative? It's very easy to increase the bids compared to competition and get customers. However, this strategy will not last long. And take my word for it, we have been in the e-commerce business for the last 20 years. And one needs to have their own compelling reasons, the brand pull for the customers to come back. And please plan your marketing strategy basis on projected revenue, considering long-term goals like ATV and LTV of the customer. Which brings me to the last point. How effective and efficient is performance marketing for brand building? Performance marketing and brand building go hand in hand. While we are doing brand marketing, companies no longer care primarily about simply achieving awareness. They need conversions, leads. Therefore, there must be some agile process that includes cross-functional collaboration for effective and efficient marketing. Is base creation a part of the vocabulary? In performance marketing teams, we are very good at tactically getting a customer with spends. We can achieve today's KPI or tomorrow's KPI. However, how do we ensure that we have the same customer coming to us next time without any marketing intervention? Are we cognizant to that fact? And this brings me to the last point here. As long as there is innovation in product and services the company is offering, brand will grow. Concluding, to give a metaphor, performance marketing can be used for the thrust on a runway for a takeoff in a marketing campaigns. However, it has to be supplemented with best practices and has to run concurrently along with strong other marketing techniques like SEO retention, all the while keeping costs in mind. And this should result into a stronger and a long-lasting business. Hope you guys have a great session in the following times. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Garia, for sharing your valuable thoughts. Truly very informative. Friends, let's not keep these insights to ourselves. Type the hashtag ET Performance Marketing on social media and share your learnings with your peers. time for the next session. Stay tuned.